Hey everyone, it's Kevin. Welcome back to the channel. I'm really excited about this video because I've been experimenting with a new grease pencil feature coming in the next Blender update, version 4.3, which is currently in beta, and that's compatibility with geometry nodes. If you're not familiar, Blender's grease pencil lets you draw and animate 2D directly in 3D space. And because it's built in, it integrates well with all the other amazing features. Now, the newest update includes compatibility with geometry nodes, which is a system that allows for procedural modeling and effects. If you've seen any of my videos before, you know that I've used this combination to create fun projects like moving plants, blooming roses, animated patterns, and other hand-drawn assets. And if you want to check out some of those projects, I'll leave links to them below. Up until now, Grease Pencil's integration with geometry nodes was limited to just instancing objects, which was still awesome. But with this new update, you can actually affect the strokes themselves. For example, you can now instantly convert your grease pencil strokes into meshes. This conversion was possible before, but this integration now makes it seamless and allows you to build upon that even further. This also means you can keep those unique grease pencil modifiers when working. This opens the door to so many possibilities for grease pencil and hybrid workflows. So I made this piece to demonstrate a shader I created in Eevee for the previous video, and if you want to check that out, I'll leave a link below. But while I was working on it, I thought it'd be fun to try out the new grease pencil and geometry node support in Blender 4.3 for some of the effects. In this video, I'm first going to do a quick breakdown of this piece and then a tutorial to create one of the assets I used here, which is this drawn mesh line. I'll also have this as a free download on my Gumroad so you can experiment with it. This tutorial and that file will only work in Blender 4.3, which you can download the beta version from the official website blender.org. Also, keep in mind that if you are going to convert a file made in a previous Blender version that contains grease pencil objects into 4.3, it will not be possible to downgrade to the original version you made it in. Although grease pencil will behave the same way, this update also includes a major overhaul for grease pencil on the back end. Let's get started. This piece features Tony Chopper, a character from One Piece. He's the adorable doctor of the Straw Hat Pirates, which is why you see potions, tablets, and elixirs surrounding him. I originally created this piece 4 years ago using Procreate, and it's actually one of the very first videos I posted on this channel. At the time, I was trying to get back into working with different creative programs and thought it'd be fun to do some time lapses. I really liked how simple and charming the original piece was, so I decided to recreate it in 3D and experiment with it. The process involved modeling, using grease pencil, and finishing it off with some effects. I first pulled in the reference and started by modeling Chopper, focusing on his body and the bowl in front of him. Since I wasn't planning on going beyond a 3D illustration, I just focused on capturing the proportions as much as possible. With the body done, I moved on to the bottles, tablets, and other diagonal design elements. These were simple spheres and cylinders that I extruded and sculpted into the right shapes. Then I applied the Toon shader, which gave it a textured, grainy look. This shader only works with Eevee and uses the shader to RGB node to get that cell shaded effect, combined with other nodes to achieve this illustrated style. This also includes the background, and if you want to see how I made this shader, I'll leave a link below to the full video. To complete the look, I added outlines on the meshes using the inverted hull method. Next, I used grease pencil to draw the finer details on Chopper, like his hat, face, and body. I also used it to add detail lines to other objects in the scene, like the bowl and some of the floating design elements. To complete the look, I drew a few more abstract elements in the background and set them to different blending modes for a layered effect, then finished it off with some compositing glare nodes. At first, I considered the piece done, but then I decided to add some subtle animations. I separated all of the grease pencil strokes into individual objects and parented them to their respective meshes. Then I animated them slightly, adding a cyclic modifier to create a looping effect and stepped interpolation to lower the frame rate. Since it wasn't going to be possible to revert this file back to version 4.2 after saving it in 4.3, I made sure to finalize everything I could. I used the default textured brushes from the Grease Pencil Tools add-on quite a bit, and I had some issues with them in 4.3 beta, so I made sure to add them in this version. I also created a glowing particle system rising from the bowl using simulation nodes, which was fun to experiment with. Once I was finished, I brought the file into Blender 4.3 to try out the new grease pencil and geometry nodes feature. Honestly, I didn't really use it extensively, just enough to experiment and create these diagonal lines in the background, but it was great. Up until now, even though grease pencil worked well with the other features, I always treated it as something very specific within Blender. For instance, it has its own set of modifiers and sculpting tools. But with this new workflow, I can now use those same functions on what effectively can become a mesh. In this case, I created these drawn mesh lines, and in the next part, I'll walk you through how to make them. For this part, I'm going to walk you through the geometry node setup for the drawn mesh assets. I'll also have a project file available that's configured for the non-photorealistic style you saw in the previous piece. So here, I'm in a new Blender file, version 4.3 beta. First, I'll delete the default cube and bring in a grease pencil stroke object. Then I'll switch the dope sheet to the geometry node editor and create a new node system. Start by adding a grease pencil to curves node, followed by a curve to mesh node with fill caps checked. Technically, I don't think you need the grease pencil to curves node for this setup because grease pencil strokes are already defined as curves in 4.3, but I'm including it for clarity and to ensure compatibility. Next, bring in a curve circle node and plug it into the profile curve input. Now we have the original grease pencil stroke converted into a 3D mesh. I added a couple of extra nodes to refine the look, starting with the tapered ends. While you can taper it as a grease pencil stroke, I wanted a more uniform appearance across these strokes when they become meshes. To achieve that, bring in a set curve radius node and place it after the group input. Next, bring in a spline parameter node and connect the factor output to the radius input. This controls the variation along the curve. To refine it, add a math node after the spline parameter and set it to subtract. This setup creates a gradient effect along the curve by adjusting the starting point. Then duplicate the math node and set the new one to absolute. This flips any negative values to positive, ensuring a smooth taper on both ends. Finally, duplicate the subtract node one more time and place it after the absolute node. Now we have tapered ends, but they still look too large. To fix this, adjust the radius in the curve circle node to something smaller, around 0.25 meters. And now, whenever you draw a stroke in draw mode, your strokes will always appear tapered. There's a few additional nodes I added in the project file specifically for materials. To quickly go over that, starting from the curves to mesh node, there are two main connections, one for the main material, which is the texture tune shader, and the other for the outline. This outline uses the inverted hull method, but in a geometry node setup. So I created an outline emission material with backface culling enabled, and these nodes essentially mimic the behavior of a solidify modifier. After that, I joined these elements together with a join geometry node and set the shading to smooth. And that's it. To finish it off, you can also add grease pencil modifiers like noise and length. Just make sure they come before the geometry node's modifier in the stack. And that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it and hope it was helpful. This project was fun to experiment with and I'm super excited about the update. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks again and see you all in the next video.